Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's showtime.
All right, everybody. Well, welcome back. We're here today. We are doing a review. Today I'm doing something that I like doing. I'm looking forward to doing it. One of my viewers, a good guy, really great, loyal supporter of Mike Stogie's, and overall a really, really decent guy, who I follow on Twitter, Corey. I believe it's at CZERBE on Twitter. Follow him. Really great guy. But anyways, he sent me a cigar. As we've been doing some bets on and off all year, and I hate to say it, but I've been winning most of them. But anyways, he sent me three cigars, and one of them he sent me, it was it's unbanded, and it's unbanded for a reason. He asked me to review it as a blind review, and here's the sealed envelope, and I'll come up. As you can see, it's still sealed, and he said, this is the band for the sticks. If you want to do a blind review, see if you can guess the stick. And the funny thing about a blind review is it really opens your mind, because when you have a band, you know what you're smoking. You can go on the internet, you can get all the information, you know, you could see what other people thought of it and stuff. And but when it's a blind review, you have no clue. It really shows that you don't know shit. And I'm about to prove that, unless I get lucky and I guess right, because that's all it's going to be. So what I'll do is at the end of the video, when I'm down to the final part, I'm going to tell you how what I get and everything like that. But I'll do it on camera. I'll open up the envelope, see if I'm right or wrong, and then I'll be able to hopefully give you some information about the cigar. Well, I probably won't unless I go online. So unless he put it in there, I don't know. It's pretty thick. But anyways. So that's what we're doing today. Today we are doing a blind review. I can tell you that the stick is a 5.5 by 50/52. It's a box press cigar. But that's pretty much all I can tell you on it. It's packed nice, nice box press, very minimal veins. We'll see what we get off the wrapper. Off the wrapper, I'm getting really nothing. And on the foot, I'm getting a sweetness. It's a nice looking wrapper. It's even hard to take a guess. I don't know. Maybe Dominican, Nicaragua, we'll find out. But let's snip it. Let's see what we get. Perfect draw. Oh, I'm getting a lot of sweet tobacco. We're going to light it up with the blue flame. Take a little longer, but I'll tell you, do this one time. If you do a trade with someone, do a blind review, man. Even not to review it, but just to smoke the cigar. I'll tell you, really, it's fun, and it really shows you, you know, how much we all think we know. I'm getting a very small zing, a little zing to it. With a strong, strong leather note. So what I'll do is I'll smoke it halfway, tell you what I get, come back, and then we'll smoke the final half, come back, and then we'll open the concealed envelope, and we'll see how stupid I really am. And I'm not ashamed to say it, because 99.9% of the time you're gonna get the same thing I get, probably wrong. So, but let's sit back, let's have fun. Corey, this is for you, buddy. I hope you enjoy it, and I'll be right back in a moment. All right, everybody, we are back here with our blind review, and that doesn't mean my eyes are closed. It means I have no damn idea what we're smoking. Anyways, first half. I tell you, this cigar's got me thinking. I got like 10 cigars in my mind. I'm getting this zing, this little chocolate spice, and it's throwing me off from what I think it is. I'm getting lots of leather. Like I said, I'm getting that nice chocolate spice. I'm getting some wood as well in the cigar, not myself. Oh, maybe I am. I can't tell you if I am. But anyways, so I'm getting wood. I'm getting leather. I'm getting this chocolate spice. My guess in the first half, I really thought it was a CAO Brasilia. I'm kind of still there, but I'm not sure. It could be several other cigars. I'm thinking it might be a Tatuaje, but I'm not positive because the box press is throwing me off. Not that he doesn't make a box press, it's just throwing me off. So I'm stuck. But anyways, right now I'm kind of leaning towards a CAO Brasilia, but I could be wrong. But it's going really good. Lots of touch-ups though. I mean, I really need to pay the cigar attention. It could be, it's only been in my humidor 4 days maybe since Corey shipped it to me. But nice draw. I mean, I'm digging it. I'm enjoying it. It's definitely a decent stick. But I'll tell you, these blind reviews, man, makes you really think about what you're smoking. I'm thinking it might be Nicaraguan because of that zing, that chocolate spice zing that I'm getting. But I'm not sure. Again, we won't know until the end when I open it up. But so far, going good. I'm enjoying it. We're going to get down to the final half. A little quick review here on a blind review. And again, I want to thank Corey a lot. This is fun. It's enjoyable. I'm digging it. And I'll be right back. So don't go anywhere. Alrighty, folks. We are back here in the final half. And I'm wearing it in our blind review. And I'll tell you, it's... The cigar isn't overly complex. The second half, same as the first. Still getting the woody notes. Still getting the leather. That spicy chocolate is there. It's definitely there in the retrohale. Burn still needed attention. But overall, it was a good stick. It was a good stick. It wasn't a wow stick. It was a good stick. We do have the sealed envelope. As you can see, it's sealed. It's not open. I'm not sure. I'm going to stick with the CAO Brasilia. I could be wrong. But we're about to find out on camera what I thought. I think it's Nicaraguan, but I could be wrong. I'm not even sure if CAO Brasilia is Nicaraguan. I didn't look it up. Again, I'm guessing. So I'm going to take another puff now. Lots of smoke. The one thing I will say, it did get very spongy. That's one thing I will tell you. But I'm going to put the cigar down over here. And we're going to open this up on camera again. Corey, thanks, man. It's fun. I love doing these blind reviews. I did it once before with Tony Casa. Really fun. But let's open this bad boy. As you can see, I'm ripping it open on the top. So I have no clue. Corey's even got it in another envelope. So there. So now you know. I got to open up another envelope. Man, Corey, you didn't want me to know, did you? And... it is, I'm wrong. I can tell you that by just looking at the back of the band. Wow. Okay, it is an Oliva Master's Blend. I'll come up here for you. An Oliva Master's Blend number 3. So I've smoked it before, thought it was a decent stick, as I recall. But I was wrong, and that just goes to show you that if you don't know with looking at the band what you're smoking, it really changes up, because you could get something that was an ass okay stick and you could think it was really good after smoking it the second time, which I believe I thought that the Oliva Master's Blend number 3. I'm not sure if I reviewed it, but I believe I thought it was a good stick. Again, I don't think it was a wow stick. But I want to thank Corey. I hope you guys enjoyed the blind review. It was fun. If there's anything you guys want me to try, you want me to do a blind review again, let me know. I'd be happy to. So that's it for today. And as I always tell you, enjoy your smokes.